Hello everyone, welcome to Dynamo 102 tutorial series. This is part one, and I'm actually going to split this part one into two separate sessions. So it's going to be two steps. In the first step, we're going to talk about how to create a filter. We're going to also talk about rules, parameters, multi-category filters, and so on. And then in the second step, we're going to apply that same filter or multiple filters to views, and we're going to talk about setting visibility graphic overrides for those filters. So let's get started. You can see on my screen is a sample one file available for you in the downloads. And I also created two views that we're going to be using today. So what I want to do with the view filters is that I want to highlight my fire rating on the walls and doors. So if you click on any one of these walls and scroll all the way down, you can see there's a fire rating parameter here, and this one's set to 1. There might be some other ones set to 2, yes. So basically I want to create two filters and color walls that are rated 1 hour in one color, and then color the other ones with a different color setting, and apply those two filters to any view that contains fire rating in its name. That way we can showcase Dynamo's ability to quickly process multiple view filters and override their settings kind of on the fly. So let's get started with Dynamo so we can launch our new Dynamo session. And I already mentioned that Dynamo now resides in the Manage tab, so we're going to be launching it from Manage tab, and this is Dynamo 1.0. Just start the new session really quickly. So in the previous video we talked about there's a new library over here on the left called ArchiLab. And the first view that we're going to be doing over here is creating a filter. So let's just drop in a node called create filter. And it has three inputs, its name, category, and a rule. So we're going to get started with creating a rule for the view filter. So there's another node over here on the left called create rule. So the first input is a category. So if I just right click on canvas and search for categories, you can see a second one over here. It's a drop-down node, so we can just open it up and search for walls. And again, just like I mentioned in the first video, I'm kind of making an assumption that most of you are familiar with Dynamo, most of you are familiar with the interface, and I'm going to be doing a little bit of shortcuts, so I'm going to be using right-click search menu a lot more than I did in my Dynamo 101 video, where I actually went through the library and searched for things there. Okay, so let's get back to it. First thing we want to do is apply that filter to wall category. So we're just going to plug in our walls. And the next input is a parameter name. So this is the name of the parameter that we apply in the filter to. And you can see that parameter down here on the bottom. So its name is fire rating. So if we just go back to Dynamo real quickly. Again, one of the shortcuts that I like to use is double-click on canvas and open up a code block. This allows me to use parentheses like this, I mean quotation marks like this, to create a string for the parameter name. So I can do fire rating. And this would be a substitute for something like searching for a string and then typing in fire rating. So you can see doing it with a node is two steps versus I can just really quickly double-click and type in my desired string name. So I'm going to be using code blocks for this purpose. It's just faster for me. So this will be my parameter name. And I want to create a rule that checks if that parameter is set to 1. So my parameter value will be an integer. And then again, I can do an integer slider. So I'm searching and setting it to 1. Or I can simply double-click and just punch in 1 code block so much faster. So again, I'm just going to leave that code block on. So here is a parameter value. And then the rule type, it's another one of the drop-down nodes over here on the left. And these will have a couple of rules that are available to us. And we're looking for one that says equals. So basically we're saying, give me all of the walls where the fire rating is equals to 1. So we're going to take that rule type and plug it in here. So this is our first rule that we've created, and then we can add it to our create filter node. And then for the category, it will be the exact same category that we use for the filter. And then for the name, we can just again double click and create a name for our filter. So let's just call it fire rating dash one. So that will be a name for our filter. So we just effectively created a new filter, and just to quickly see that, I'm using a keyboard shortcut called VV or VG that brings up the visibility graphics overrides menu in our view, and then we can go to filters. And again, this filter isn't applied to the view yet, so we have to click on edit new, and you're going to see that over here, rule-based filters. And it should be applied to a wall category, and it should say fire rating equals one. So this is exactly what we've been working on just now in Dynamo. So a couple of things that we can do before we move on. I want to talk about multiple categories. So we mentioned that we want to apply this filter to more than a single category. So how would you do that? So if you select this category now, then just Control C, Control V, we can search for another category called doors. And then if we use a node called list.create, you should be familiar with this component from a Dynamo 101 series. It allows you to combine multiple elements into a list of elements. So we're going to take these two categories, and this would give us a list of categories. So you can see there's a list with two elements on it. So now, instead of plugging that single category into our input category, we can plug in a list into both of these inputs. So now if we go back to our Dynamo session for, Revit session for a second, and click on that fire rating filter, you can see that it's now applied to doors and walls at the same time. So that's working pretty well so far. Another thing that I wanted to mention is, I'm just going to briefly talk about this really quickly. The second input to this filter, create rule node, is a parameter name. And if you hover over it, you see that it says parameter or built-in parameter. And for example, room underscore name. I hope that everyone is familiar with the concept of the built-in parameter. Sometimes when you're dealing with multiple parameters, having the same name, being able to use the built-in parameter is kind of really important, because those are the parameters that are pointing specifically just at the single thing. If you select a parameter by its name, it might be two parameters with the same name, and that might confuse Revit sometimes. So these components allow you to use built-in parameter name or a regular parameter name. So that's one thing I want to talk about. Another thing that we can do over here, probably, we can create a filter with multiple rules. So for the purpose of this exercise, a single rule is just fine, but I want to show you really quickly, we're going to probably delete it later. What if we wanted to have multiple rules? What if we wanted to say, well, give me all the walls where the fire rating is equal to 1, but it's less than 3. This will kind of, the two rules kind of cancel each other out, but let's just see this for the sake of argument. So what if we created another rule node? We would apply exact same categories to it. We would apply the same parameter name to it. And then we would change the inputs for the value. So let's just say we want to say, oh, it's less than 3. So that will be our parameter value. And then our rule type would be less than. There you go. So this effectively creates another rule for our filter. And what we can do with that is, again, we can search for list.create, and we can combine these rules together. So I'm just going to really quickly combine them into a list. So now I have a list with two rules. In Revit, when you're making rules, you only have ability to add three rules to filter. What I found with the Revit API, with Dynamo, you can create more than three. I've tried four, and they worked, so I was a little surprised, but you can try more than that and report back to me. I'll be happy to hear from it. It actually accepts. But let's just take that list of these rules, and instead of plugging a single rule into create filter, we can plug a list of rules into this component. And what happens is, if we now go to visibility graphics and look at that filter, you will see that now it has a rule that says fire rating equals to 1, but also fire rating is less than 3. So now we have two rules. And all of the rules in Revit, when they pertain to filters, are AND rules. So you're combining this rule and this rule. They both have to be true for it to be passed through the filter. So instead of creating a second rule like this, let's just create another filter, because we have, I mentioned two walls, so we're going to have ones that are rated 1 hour and ones that are rated 2 hours. So let's just change this to equals to two. Instead of feeding it through a list, we're just going to create another filter. So this will be our rule. This will be our categories. And then we'll have a new name called fire rating. Let's just do dash two. So we have a filter rule for walls that are rated 1 hour and walls that are rated 2 hours. So that will be my name. And if we go back to Revit, just to quickly see if it's working properly, filters, add a new, we should have first fire rating rule and then the second fire rating rule. They're there. That's it for the first part, the first step of this tutorial. And in the second step, I want to take these and then apply them to views and then set some visibility graphics overrides. So hang in there and we'll be right back.